the league last year in passing touchdowns and passing yards. With more on this story and Brett Favre returning to Minnesota, NFL Live's Mark Schlaer is joining us in studio, and we bring in Hall of Fame quarterback Warren Moon on the phone. And Mark, let's start with you first. What did you hear from Brett Favre just minutes ago?
Well, obviously, you know what? His desire to play was there for his teammates, which he basically said those guys coming down there are really what pushed him over the edge. But anytime you've played this game for any length of time, obviously your body's going to take a beating. But I think the one thing that really stuck out for me was it's not so much the physical beating. All of us can overcome some of the physical ailments that we have. It comes down to the arduous task that is football from the mental side, getting over the losses, getting yourself prepared to play week in, week out, and getting yourself prepared to practice, I think, is one of the big things. I mean, coming game day on Sunday, the adrenaline starts flowing. You feel pretty good about where you're at. It's preparing to get to Sunday. That's the hard part, and that's what I heard from Favre is the mental anguish that he went through after that loss is really what made this decision so difficult for him.
Warren, as a quarterback who's been through many battles in the playoffs, how tough is it to mentally come back?
You know, it's really tough because you put your heart and soul into a season, and everybody has the same goals starting out, and only a few teams realistically have the chance to win a Super Bowl. And those Vikings were one of the favorites last year to do that, and they got ever so close. So when you get that close to what you wanted to accomplish at the beginning of the season and it comes to an end like that, it takes a tremendous physical toll on you. It takes a tremendous psychological toll on you. And you really wonder if you ever want to play the game again, especially when you're that age. But Brett Favre, I don't think there's any question about his love for the game and how much he still wants to play it.
Warren, why do you think he needed to be convinced, though, especially with the trio of Allen, Longwell, and Hutchinson going down to Mississippi?
I don't think it's a matter of him having to be convinced. I think still in his mind right now, sitting at that podium at that press conference, he's still wondering if his body can take him through another maybe 20-game season, if that's what it takes to get to the Super Bowl. So there's still those questions because Brett Favre, what makes him special to me is not so much his arm strength and all that, because me at 51 years old or 53 years old right now, I could probably still make a lot of the same throws, but I think having his feet and his legs up under him are something that's very important, and that's what makes him special. And he can't be the special player that he is if he can't move around and buy time and make things happen like he did before. And I think that's what his big question was coming into this season. Is that ankle going to allow him to be the special player that he is?
Warren, let's follow up on that. You played until you were 44. When you got into your 40s, how tough was it every Monday waking up and getting your body back together for 6 days of football?
You know, it really wasn't that different for me. And I'm sure if you talk to a lot of guys or a lot of quarterbacks, they'll probably say the same thing. It depends on how physical that game was to you, whether you were knocked around a lot, whether you were sacked a lot, or if it was a game where you weren't touched a whole lot, it wasn't much different coming back on Tuesday or Wednesday. But I had a pretty good regimen of things that I did after the ball game to get me back prepared to play, and I started that pretty early in my career, and it really helped me as far as getting myself refreshed. So I felt pretty good by Wednesday's practice.
Mark, let's talk a little bit about the teammates flying down. You weren't really happy with how Minnesota handled things last year with bringing in Brett Favre. What's different this year?
Well, last year I just didn't like the fact that the team set basically standards or set parameters. Hey, you have to report at this date, otherwise we don't want you. Oh, wait, not that date. Let's move it to this date. Oh, and that was not only the speculation, but that's what everybody was talking about. So that was really the issue for me. Brett Favre is Brett Favre. He has a different set of standards. The guy's one of the greatest that's ever played the game. So I was just like, hey, the guy's played 19 years. Come in when you want to come in. We're going to go out and try to win a championship. This year, sending those guys down basically to coax him out of retirement, if you will. Listen, I went through a similar situation in my time with the Denver Broncos. Gary Zimmerman is a Hall of Famer, one of the greatest players that's ever played the left tackle position. We, as a football team, wanted him. He was a valuable member of that team, and he was up at Sturgis riding motorcycles during training camp, and Mike Shanahan got John Elway to fly up to Sturgis, ride motorcycles with him, and coax him to come back out of retirement. And we were so happy as a team to have him back, to have Zim back in the fold. Now, that doesn't mean we didn't give him a ton of grief, and I expect Brett Favre in that locker room is taking a ton of grief, but that's part of the game and part of what he brings, that childlike enthusiasm, that fun, the way he jumps around, the way he plays the game. He's infectious, and in the locker room, he's a jokester. Guys love that, and that's an important part of that chemistry word we always talk about as NFL players.
So we're hearing what's it like to be inside that locker room with Mark giving his example when he was at Denver. Now, Warren, if you're in the division, a team like the Packers or possibly an NFC contender like the Saints or Cowboys, what's your take on what's going on in Minnesota right now?
Well, they're probably looking back at it and saying that's probably a zoo-like atmosphere or carnival-type atmosphere. They're watching on television. They're watching the helicopters follow Brett Favre's car as he goes from the airport to the training facility, and they're wondering what's going through those players' minds, I'm sure, because I'm wondering myself how the players are dealing with all of this, even though they all want to keep a straight face and say all the positive things. I'm sure there's a certain element of the football team that might be bothered by all of this, but I think, like Mark said, once Brett gets into that locker room, his personality just kind of takes over, and the guys just kind of gravitate to him. And then when he gets on the field and starts showing what he's able to do, they quickly forget about everything that's happened in the past.
All right, there's another storyline that could be potentially be going on in the locker room. Our NFC North blogger Kevin Seifer brought up something earlier today on SportsCenter that Favre getting a bump in pay could also affect other players on the team looking for new deals. Mark, what kind of effect could this raise inside the locker room in Minnesota?
I don't think it'll have any effect at all. I mean, I think players do a good job of compartmentalizing different guys' contracts, and it's hard to compare yourself. I mean, there's nobody in that locker room that compared themselves to Brett Favre. I mean, what is this, his 20th year? He's got every conceivable record there possibly is. And I think you just look at it and say, okay, those are the Favre rules. Much like we used to talk about the Jordan rules, those are the Favre rules over there. We understand if they bump his pay, whatever. He's Brett Favre. He's our best chance to win a championship. And as a team, that's our goal. And we don't have guys that have won championships in this locker room. There's not a lot of Super Bowl rings floating around. So this is our best chance collectively to go out and accomplish this goal that we have, to be the world champion. So I don't look at that and say, oh, well, if he got more money, I'm going to run upstairs and say, well, I want more money. You can't compare yourself to Brett Favre. He's just in a different stratosphere to everybody else in that locker room.
Warren, your thoughts about this money issue potentially there? I mean, Mark says, hey, it's a different set of rules. You're a quarterback. You know a little bit about those rules.
Yeah, the quarterback is just judged very differently from the other players on the football team because he's one of the most important players, not only in football, but probably in team sports. So you treat him a little bit differently. And I think what sets him apart is the guy's a three-time MVP. He's been to a Super Bowl. He's been in the league for 20 years. If there's any player that can walk into management and say, I've done all these things, then maybe they can be put on the same plane. But there's not, so it shouldn't even be a question of whether you can compare yourself to what Brett Favre is doing or how he's being treated, unless you've done all those things in your career.
Guys, stick around here because we're going to continue this great topic about Brett Favre. And, you know, you go up and down. So does Vegas with the decision of Brett Favre. Check out what it has done in the last 2 weeks. The MGM Resorts International with the Vikings and the odds to win the Super Bowl. 6-1 on August 2nd. Then, of course, the story coming out that possibly Brett Favre contemplating retirement goes to 10-1. Then now it's back down to 6-1. Meanwhile, the Cowboys have gone up, down, and now sitting at 6-1. Green Bay is also going up, and it's affecting all these other teams that are involved. And notice the Super Bowl winning Saints, they are 12-1 favorites, and really their team remains intact. Of course, let's get a perspective from New Orleans. Favre and the Vikings open up the season with the Super Bowl champs.